Now, I obviously prefer working in person over remote. The one good thing about working remote is you do not gotta change, so.
As I drink my new juice, I think of all the mistakes I made that led me to becoming a software engineer. Like, who chooses this career path? Let's be honest.
So what I usually do before eating breakfast is I check my emails, any internship updates that my boss gives me, as well as check my own Discord server and respond to all my messages. This takes about 15 to 20 minutes, and I enjoy this time because it's relaxing, and I like to respond to people who are, you know, direct contact with me because it's like I'm closely connected with my people. Alright, so now I'm gonna actually get some work done so I can get some money, I mean experience.
What did he say?
What I'm currently working on in my internship is creating a Java-based program that parses resumes, so when the company gets an applicant, they can parse a resume really fast if they just put it within the program. And now, to do this, I'm going to be using the Sovereign API, which is this very well-known API that helps you parse resumes and parse jobs, and I'm going to basically use it to interpret data and information about the applicant. We love to write complicated code, guys. We love it. Anytime you find yourself procrastinating on Hey, cut the cameras.
How many YouTube videos?
So like, I'm okay, but no YouTube.
Oh yeah, I'll work with people, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Are you okay with being on camera?
Yeah.
Just making sure.
Okay.
Thank you. So I got my food here. My sister wanted some too, so now I got two more boxes. I'm waiting on that, and then I go back home.
The bag is secured.
It did a lot for to me. Why are you looking at the camera?
So usually after lunch, I end up finishing any remaining internship work I have for the day. Sometimes this can be a meeting with my boss or working on the application I was working on before I ate lunch. Or sometimes just reviewing past code and looking at any code reviews that my boss may have, you know, written for my code.
So at this point, I was trying to debug my program because I was getting a weird bug where I was getting null reference error. I was going through the code seeing where possibly this null reference error could be, and then I couldn't find it. So I decided to go with Stack Overflow, you know, as most smart programmers would do. I tried looking at Stack Overflow. They didn't help either. So I searched up Google and searched the deep, dark web, trying to find my answer in hopes of solving this bug. And I couldn't find it. So at this point, I was like, maybe this isn't the correct career path. I should have became a doctor like my parents wanted me to. Oh, well.
So I just finished my internship work. There was a bug in my code that I literally couldn't fix until 5 minutes ago. I definitely caused a nice headache. But now that work is over, it's time to hit the gym. So let's go.
Round two of stealing my mom's car. I know you feel like you want me, and I guess in a way you do. Holding my breath, unraveling emotions. I need some space to think this through. Call me all night long. Try to give you hints in a hard to see. Right on the line, no. Losing it on useless things.
Sometimes I have this existential crisis where, as a software engineer intern who, you know, setting himself up to work in the corporate world as a full-time software engineer within like 2 or 3 years, I think about it like, is it worth it? Am I doing the right thing? Because I know that software engineers, right, you know, it's a great life, you make good money, you are stable, but you're also working for someone else's dream, right? You're not working for yours. Like, I come from an Indian household, so say I end up working at Google. That's probably like the pride of the family at that point, right? They'll be ecstatic. I will be ecstatic because you're working at Google. But sometimes I'm just like, you know, I really want to work for the goals that I have, like the dreams that I have. I'm realizing that you can still accomplish your goals working in the corporate world, right? If anything, the money you will make and the experience you will gain, it will supplement your personal, you know, entrepreneurial adventures. So that's the way I'm looking at things now. I feel like it's a way more positive thing to look at stuff. And hopefully if you guys are going through the same thing, you know, worrying about the same thing, whether you're a software engineer or you're a doctor or a lawyer, it doesn't matter. You know, hopefully this little, you know, spiel helped you guys. I came back from the gym, I showered, and then I ate dinner. And now that it's 10 p.m., what I like to do really for the next 2 hours is I focus a lot on my side hustle work. And this consists of me writing scripts for YouTube videos sometimes. Sometimes this can be me managing my company, Smart Minds Tutoring, or it can be just me doing some client work where I actually create checkout scripts and programs for people. So basically freelance coding. I do that a lot, and I usually get all that work done in this 2 hour time frame from 10 p.m. to 12 a.m. and then I usually sleep.
As the video nears its end, I want to thank you all for sticking to the end if you made it this far. Please be sure to like the video, subscribe, and comment down below what you thought, whether you want more videos like this. Until next time, peace.